curl of a vector and Stokes theorem. Curl of a vector and Stokes theorem. This is the third important basic operator. How we can define the curl is, the curl of a vector A bar is an axial vector. Axial in the bracket is also a rotational vector. Rotational vector whose magnitude is maximum circulation of A bar per unit area So this is the definition of curl. So the curl of a vector is nothing but it is a rotation of the vector. It is a rotation of the vector whose magnitude is maximum circulation of the vector per unit area. Per unit area, that is, if you consider a small area, so the maximum circulation per unit area, nothing but the rotation of the vector around that area, the rotation of the vector around that area is defined as curl, and it is indicated by del cross A bar. We know that suppose a vector field is like this. I am considering a closed path. Closed path is nothing but a surface. So the circulation, this is a closed path. The circulation, suppose this is vector field A bar. Circulation of A bar along the closed path, is equal to integration over A bar dot dl. This is already we defined, circulation over closed path, circulation over closed line. So L is closed path. So here, but the definition of curl is nothing but this is a circulation of vector field per unit area. That is, if I consider a small area, here, so the circulation, of the vector field along this small area is nothing but curl. If you integrate, because the closed line is nothing but a open surface, if you integrate along the entire surface, the circulation of the circulation over entire area is nothing but a curl. So therefore I can define the circulation also. Circulation of A bar is given, is also equal to integration over S A bar dot ds. This is also closed surface, closed line. Closed line is nothing but closed line or open surface. So the circulation of the A bar is also equal to integration over S A bar dot ds. We can equate these two. So integration over L closed line A bar dot ds is nothing but integration over S open surface curl. Curl means, sorry, this is not A bar ds, this is del cross A bar. Integration of the curl along a entire surface. So this is del cross A bar, dot ds, so I can relate like this. So integration over L A bar dot ds is equal to integration over S del cross A bar ds. This is called Stokes theorem. So we can say that Stokes theorem relates line integrals to surface integrals, whereas divergence theorem relates surface integrals to volume integrals. So like this we can relate the curl and circulation closed line integral. So the circulation of the field is nothing but integration over closed line A bar dot dl. So we can relate both. So integration over closed line A bar dot dl, this is not ds, this is dl, is equal to open surface S del cross A ds, which is Stokes theorem, which relates line integrals to surface integrals, which is very important theorem. So in statement form, the Stokes theorem says that the circulation of a vector field A bar around a closed path L is equal to the surface integral of the curl of A bar over the open surface S bounded by L. So this is the statement form of Stokes theorem. Now we will work out a problem to verify Stokes theorem. Problem is like this. Figure is given like this. This is X, this is Y. A closed line is given like this. This is point A, point B, point C, point D. The point A is at A, 0. This is at A, B. Point C A minus A, B. Point D is at -A, 0. The movement is like this. The problem is verify Stokes theorem. So the solution to this problem is, what is Stokes theorem? Integration over closed line A bar dot dl is equal to integration over S open surface del cross A bar ds, del cross A bar ds. So first of all we will calculate line integral. Here the field is given f bar is equal to x square plus y square I bar minus 2xy j bar. So I bar is nothing but ax, j bar is nothing but ay. So generally ax, ay, az, that is one type of notation for unit vectors. Ijk is another type of notation. So here solution now. First of all we will calculate line integral A bar dot dl we will calculate. So this is equal to integral over AB plus integral over BC plus integral over CD plus integral over DA, the entire line integral, that is like this. So first of all calculate integral over AB along AB. If you calculate along AB, if you observe the points x is equal to A, x is equal to A, y is equal to 0 to B. So along AB, x is equal to constant, that is equal to A. So implies dx is equal to 0, differentiation is equal to 0. Y varies from 0 to B. Therefore integration over AB, f dot dl is equal to integration over AB, f dot dl. So here dl is nothing but, generally dl is equal to, we know dl is equal to dx ax plus dy ay plus dz az. So here ax is I bar, ay is j k. So here only ax and ay exist, remain all goes. So this is nothing but x square plus y square dx minus 2xy dy minus 2xy dy, that is equal to, since dx is equal to 0, therefore only y 0 to b minus 2xy, x is equal to a, y dy, that is equal to minus a into y square, because y square by 2, integration 2 cancels, the range 0 to b minus ab square minus ab square, so the entire thing is mathematics. So this is the line integral along ab. Now along BC, if you observe along BC y is equal to b, dy is equal to 0, implies dy is equal to 0, and x varies from a to minus a, therefore integration BC, this is x square plus y square dx minus 2xy dy, that is equal to integration a to minus a, x square plus b square dx, that is equal to x cube by 3 plus b square x in the range a to minus a, that is equal to minus 2a square by 3 minus 2a b square. Same again along CD. So along CD, x is equal to minus a, dx is equal to 0, y varies from b to 0. Therefore integration ed x square plus y square dx minus 2xy dy. You simplify this, you will get minus ab square. Similarly along DA, y is equal to 0 implies dy is equal to 0, x varies from minus a to a, therefore integration dA x square plus y square dx minus 2xy dy is equal to, substitute the values and limits, you will get 2a cube by 3. Therefore the total integration over closed line f bar dot dl is equal to addition of all this, that is minus ab square along ab plus minus 2a square by 3 minus 2ab square minus ab square plus 2a square by 3. So you will get minus 4ab square. So we have to verify by using Stokes theorem. So next calculate del cross f bar. So del cross f bar is nothing but I bar, j bar, k bar, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, x square plus y square minus 2xy 0. So you will get minus 2y k bar, that is minus 4y k bar. So here for the surface n bar is nothing but k bar. So del cross f bar dot n bar ds, this is a ds, that is normal vector, that is minus 4y k bar dot k bar, that is equal to minus 4y. Therefore integration over s del cross f bar dot n bar is equal to integration 0 to b integration minus a to a integration 0 to b minus a to a, x is varying from minus a to a, y always 0 to b, minus 4y dx dy. So this is equal to minus 4a b square. So Stokes theorem is verified. So like this you can calculate the line integral. Suppose in the examination if they ask line integral, don't go for calculation of integration over L, directly calculate del cross F, so that the problem becomes simple. Because here why I am considering this ds as k bar is, here given xy, here given xy, so ds is nothing but dx dy az bar, dx dy az bar. So that's why this az bar, that means k bar, so k bar dx dy. So that is the reason. Now we will see classification of vector fields. Classification of vector fields. Suppose a field is like this. So what is the divergence del dot A bar? Suppose this is A bar field. So divergence is zero because the field is coming and leaving as it is. Rotation, del cross A bar, rotation also zero. So divergence is zero, curl is also zero for this type of field. Suppose a field is like this. A field is represented like this. So for this, this is a diverging. The field is diverging. So del dot A bar is not equal to 0. Rotation, there is no rotation at all. Del cross A bar is equal to 0. Suppose a field is like this. Like this. So for this, it is rotating, not diverging. So del dot A is equal to 0, but curl is, rotation is not equal to 0. And finally, a field is like this. So this type of field, it is rotating as well as diverging at the same time. So del dot A is not equal to 0, del cross A is also not equal to 0. So this type of fields. Here we can say that some conclusions. A vector field is said to be solenoidal or divergenceless if del dot A bar is equal to 0. That is, if divergence is 0, then we can say that the field is a divergenceless, nothing but rotating fields. Suppose this type of field, this is like a solenoidal or divergenceless. Suppose a vector field A bar is said to be irrotational if del cross A bar is equal to 0. That is, the field is not rotating. Del cross A bar is equal to 0. This type of field, del cross A bar. This is also called as irrotational field is also called as conservative field, because del cross A is equal to 0. Del cross A is equal to 0 means, if you relate to circulation, the circulation of the field is 0. So the circulation of the field is 0 means conservativeness. That is, suppose if you take, for example, work, already we discussed work example. That is, the resultant work done is 0. Nothing but conservativeness. So, irrotational field is also known as conservative field. So, these two statements are very, very important. So, for a field is said to be solenoidal if divergence is equal to 0, that is del dot A bar is equal to 0. A vector field is said to be conservative if del cross A is equal to 0. So, this is the classification of vector fields.